Video content creation is becoming more and more of a trend, and that's because it retains human attention longer than static images or writings do. And in graphic design and media in general, this is something we need to be aware of and actually adapt with the future as it plays out in this industry. As a beginner who's not that familiar with editing softwares, it might be difficult to get access to genuinely good free editing softwares for kind of entry-level people. But here's where things can totally change. In this video, you will learn the best video editing software for beginners, its features, its pros and cons, and how AI is now integrated into video editing in a huge way. Oh, and also, you'll learn some extra tips that will take your editing process to new heights. So here we are in Filmora, which you can try for free on both Windows and Mac. And as I mentioned, Filmora have gone heavy on an array of awesome AI-based tools built right into the editor. We have things like AI Copilot Editing, AI Music Generator, AI Text Video, and a lot more. And we're going to take a look at these very, very soon. So there are also a lot of useful audio and music adaptions here as well. So if you're really into focusing on the sound aspect of your productions, that would likely come in handy. The UI and functionality of Filmora is really, really easy to pick up and use. We can move the playhead around like so and cut clips with the keyboard shortcut of Control or Command B. And here on the UI icon panel, we can actually quickly do things like crop our clips and a few other important workflow tools as well. Also, a pro tip, you can hover over a tool to show its keyboard shortcut, which is pretty cool. But yeah, Filmora's UI layout and functionality is intuitive and it's easy to use without much in the way of actual previous editing knowledge. Okay, so let's look at the truly powerful and amazing elements that I know you want to see. It's the AI tools. So here we have the AI text-based editing, and this takes the transcription of a video to where you can then edit the text, which ultimately edits the video in real time. Sounds crazy, I know, but it's actually a thing. It might take a while to convert, but once it's ready, we export it onto our timeline like so. And just to test it out, we can play the video back to see if it has indeed transcribed things perfectly. One really handy upshot of Filmora is that we have a library of built-in resources to make use of, and that can be found right here. Now, if you want to make use of something on your project, you just click the download icon and add it to your project. And this can take a while sometimes. But get this, I'm going to show you a super powerful tool, the Smart Cutout tool. So I have a clip of a guy walking along here. But if I crop it in a certain way and then turn on the Smart Cut option, the AI will instantly recognize that I want to cut out the guy on the clip. Now we do have options here to neaten up any cuts and to be more precise, but look how quick and easy that was. Now we just wait for the render to track it over the entire clip. And in seconds, we have a cutout. But like I said, you can take your time to be more precise and get a cleaner cut. This is just a quick demo. As I mentioned before, there are a lot of AI music tools with Filmora. The music generator gives you some categories where we can actually generate music based on certain moods and then adjust the tempo below. This is a quick example, but we could go into the theme or genre options and narrow down our preferred style of music even more. This is useful so we don't actually get copyright issues on any of our work, and we just then download the music and slap it onto our timeline. Easy. But stepping away from AI for a moment, Filmora also has some of the easiest ways to pull off some of the most important and fundamental editing tricks. Take, for example, speed ramping. This is where we can speed up and slow down shots in various different ways, and that is to make them more interesting and more engaging. Again, the UI is really easy to use and understand right out of the gate. And another vital technique in editing is motion tracking. And with Filmora, we don't need to mess around with drawing masks and lines. The software itself automatically picks out the guy walking with just a few clicks. And see, just like that, it's tracked for the entire clip. And with this, we could do all kinds of things, but as a quick demo, we can play some text that moves along with him as he walks. And yeah, it took less than a minute to achieve this. Pretty cool. So I often get a lot of questions asking me about my video editing process, and people want to know how to get started with video editing. Filmora is a great entry-level editor, not only because it's easy to use, but because the new features actually give you access to some of the most cutting-edge tools and techniques. Filmora can be slow at times and a bit laggy in certain situations, especially when downloading content from the editor. Also, as it's not an advanced editing software, it won't have some of these super advanced tools that you might find in a few other advanced editing softwares. But like I said, Filmora is a great entry-level software, and even intermediate editors will be able to find use here with their workflows. But if you want to check out Filmora, just click the link in the description box below, and thanks to them for teaming up with Satori Graphics and allowing me to show you guys a pretty decent entry-level video editing software. I only ever bring on brands onto this channel if they, well, have a good track record, but also do offer some kind of value to creatives, and that does apply here for sure. If you want to watch any of my other 8-year catalog of free content on graphic design, just click one of these videos on screen. But until next time, guys, design your future today. Peace.